Man's World 365. We're here celebrating rising stars. I'm here with Jay Williams, and I'm here with Humanitarian of the Year, Heather Robinson. What's going on, Heather?
I'm all good. I'm doing my thing. You know, I commend Jay for all his efforts, what he's doing with Rising Stars. This is a true athlete that gives back to a philanthropy that I think, you know, is 100%. Rising Stars is really doing a lot of things for the youth. And then, you know, me and Cliff support that.
Right, absolutely. Now, how did you come and bring about Rising Stars into fruition?
Well, first off, let me say this. I love your presentation voice.
Thank you.
Just flipped it on me real quick. I like that.
Appreciate
though.
That.
And secondly, for me, you know, I'm born about 20 minutes outside of Newark, New Jersey. And I was fortunate enough to have a mom who worked multiple jobs. My dad worked into the city, kind of commuted back and forth. And our whole initiative is to take kids out of their environment and to get them to be focused on things that they should be focused on. Instead of, you know, playing dice on the corner, instead of being involved in mischievous things, you know, focus on your education and academics. And, you know, some of these kids, they want to be professional athletes. So my whole thing to them is, hey, listen, are you ready to be your own CEO? You know, are you going to start an LLC? Are you going to start S Corp? Do you know that if you're a professional basketball player, you get taxed in every city that you play in? Trying to help them think about the bigger picture. I know a lot of people want to be rappers, want to be whatever, and that's fine. But think about how you're going to leave something and create longevity, not only for yourself and your wife and your kids, but let's think about something bigger. Like leave a legacy for their kids and their kids. Think outside the box.
Definitely. It's more to life than just things that's glamorous. So how did you become Humanitarian of the Year?
You know, honestly, I was like thinking to myself, well, why the hell did they pick me? Because, you know, what is the humanitarian? And I said it tonight in my speech. Is it because I just can't say no to people? Because I wear my heart on my sleeve, and people ask me all the time. They say, Heather, I need a favor. Heather, can you do this? Heather, can Cliff come here? And then I answer for him. I'm always answering for him. Can Cliff come to this? And I answer for him. And so to answer that, I think it's just something that you're born with. You're born with that giving heart that you can't let go of, and that's a true humanitarian.
Let's talk about how your life changed after the accident. How did your life go into a different phase where you just said, you know what, I'm gonna focus on something different and I'm not turning back?
Well, first off, let me say this about Heather. You know, there's a great song that I actually love by Wale and Rick Ross. It's called Ambition. Right, she talks about what she was born with. She was born with ambition. You know, her ambition helps her get to the place where she is now. And Clifford is very fortunate that he found a wife like this where they can collectively come together to do things differently. For me, as an athlete, I don't consider myself an athlete. I first off consider myself a businessman. I just happen to be blessed to perform at a high level athletically. And this is how I try to help kids think outside the box. You know, so many kids say to me, oh, I want to be a basketball player. And I say, that's fine. But I don't want to hear this excuse, oh, this is what I fell back on my education. No, you use your education first, you fall back on basketball. And we see all these people do these videos, and we see the bling, and we see, you know, the watches and the jewelry and the Rolls Royces, and people think that's money. I'm like, that's not money.
Right.
Try to own a block in New York City.
Right.
Try to own a building in New York City. And that's longevity. And that's where we're looking outside
we're
the box.
That to your community. Exactly. And have a store
and
in your
thing.
Community.
If you're able to build that legacy for your family, that's when you sit back and you look back and say, okay, I recognize where I came from. Now I want to go back into the same area I was born and help other kids get it. Don't let them be lost in the same, you know, dangerous circle that we see every single day. So many kids get caught up in, man. It's about something bigger than yourself.
Absolutely. Now, what do you have planned for later this year?
Well, we have something coming up with Charles Oakley.
Okay.
And Penny Hardaway at we're going to do this thing over in New Jersey, if all goes well, at Miller's Sports Bar in Paramus. And what we're going to do is a promotional thing and help all three of their charities raise a little money.
And if worse come to worse, Charles Oakley will put somebody in the headlock.
Yes, he will.
And make you
yes.
donate
you
some
get
to
great
this
marketing
charity.
Material. How about that?
Definitely. Man's World 365, Jay Williams, Heather Robinson, Rising Stars. Appreciate what they're doing and also support them, y'all. Peace.